So what are the basic types of pattern? So I already said that there are three types of patterns, that is arch, loop and whorl. Arch, loop and whorl. So one more is there. First one is arch, then loop, third one is whorl, and one fourth one is there, that is composites. So mainly we classify the patterns into three, that is arch, loop and whorl, and one more is there, that is composites. So these composites we can include in whorl only, that is whorl we can divide into central pocket loops or twin loops or lateral pocket loops, accidentals like that. So a further classification just like this, we are adding composites. So under composites it comes central pocket loop, twin loop, lateral pocket loop, accidentals like that. So these are the basic classification of fingerprints. So once again I will tell with the symbols. So arches, arch is two types. Arch we can represent by the symbol A. There are two types, planar and tended arc. So planar is A and tended arc is T. So this is the symbol arc. Two types of arc are there, planar with the symbol A and tended arc with the symbol T. Then loops, there are two types of loops, ulnar loop and radial loop. So ulnar loop we can give the symbol U, and radial loop we can give the symbol R. So ulnar loop is U and radial loop is R. Then whorls we can give the W symbol, whorls. And next composites, or we can divide this into like a whorl only, that is central pocket loop CP. Central pocket loop is CP. Double whorl loop, or we can say twin loop, that is TL. TL. Then accidental AC, and one more is there, that is lateral pocket loop. Lateral pocket loop, that is LP. So this is the classification of patterns of the fingerprints. Now let's see the definitions of each patterns. So first one is arch. So these are the patterns account for approximately 5% of recorded fingerprints. So arc we can see 5% among the total population. And in this pattern, the ridges run from outside of the print to the other side. So how is it? The ridges run from one side of the print to the other, as the name implies, in an arc-like fashion, that is like this, from one side to the other side, like this the ridge patterns run from one side to the other side in an arch-like pattern. So these are off, and there is no recurving ridges in arch. So like loop, there is no recurving, only the ridges run from one side to the other side. So there are two types of arch, plain arch and tended arch. So plain arch, what I told, like A we can give as a symbol and tended arch we can give T. So plain arch is the simplest of all fingerprint patterns. This is the simplest one of all fingerprint patterns. And plain arc is formed by the ridges entering the pattern of on the left, from left flowing smoothly towards the right, from left to right of the pattern, with a small rise in the center resembling a hill or hump. So that is plain arch. Then next is standard arch. This pattern is which most but not all the ridges enter the pattern on the left side or tend to flow to the right side, with one or more ridges in the center forming either a definite angle or standing almost straight up. So like a thrust. You can see here the difference. Here in plain arch, all the ridges are flowing. Here you can see like this in an upright form, in a almost in a straight form. So this pattern, not all the ridges will not go to the right side from the left side. So here you can write, not all will go to left from right, and in the center, there is almost a standing or straight up is there in the center, like a thrust. So this is arch pattern. So arch we can see only 5% in the total population, and the ridges run from one side of the print to the other side in an arc like fashion, and no recurving ridges are formed in the arc like a loop. Then there are two types of arch pattern, plain arch and tended arch. So plain arch is the simplest form of all the fingerprints, and all the ridges run from left to right. And in tended arch T, we can give the symbol T, but in this not all the ridges will flow from left to right, and in the center portion there will form a definite angle or a standing or almost straight up. So this will form a thrust there. So next one is loop. So loops, 60 to 65% of all the patterns are of loop. So in the total population we can see about 60 to 65% of loop. And a loop is formed by one or more ridges entering at one side of the pattern. So how we can write, loop is formed by one or more ridges entering at one side of the pattern, continuing up to the center of the pattern, and recurving around a core to form a loop. So loop is formed by one or more ridges entering at one side of the pattern, continuing up to the center of the pattern, and recurving. So there is a recurving in loop around a core to form a loop. Then again, flowing back and terminate at the other side. At the same side, of the pattern from which they entered. So here you can see, this is a loop here you can see clearly, this is the loop. So from one one side it is entering. From one side the ridges are entering and then recurving at the center portion, and again flowing back to the same region of the from where it entered. So it will come like this and form a curve in the center and again come back to the portion from where it formed. So like a loop it is forming. So this is called loop. So there is a core, there will be a core at the center. And it always has a delta also. So loop contains a core and a delta. Loop contains a delta and a core and at least one ridge passing freely between the core and delta. At this stage, it is necessary to define delta and core to correctly interpret the patterns, because last time when I explained about delta, I think some of you had some doubts. So what is a core and what is a delta? So first we'll see the core. The core, or we can say the inner terminus. Inner terminus is the approximate center of the portion of the pattern. So this core or the inner terminus, we can say this is the approximate center of the pattern, and the type of core varies according to the pattern. So arch pattern, they do not have any cores because they are forming like this. So there is no core in arch pattern, but loops and whorls have core. Loops and whorls, they have core, and the core in loops is located on or within the innermost recurving ridge based on a series of prescribed rules. So what is core? Core is the approximate center of the pattern. So I can show you here, this is a core of the world. This is the core. So this is the innermost portion of the world, that is core. So here also you can see the core. Here there is a core. This is core. Here this is the core region. And what is delta? So core is the inner terminus and delta is the outer terminus. So this may be formed either by bifurcation of a single ridge or by abrupt divergence of with because of two things it will happen. One is bifurcation of single ridge, or by the abrupt divergence. So next is divergence of two ridges running side by side. So in bifurcation, one is bifurcation and another one is divergence. By these two means delta can form in the loop and whorl. So delta is called outer terminus, and in the first case, that is in the bifurcation, the point of bifurcation forms the point of delta. So the point of bifurcation forms the point of delta. And in the next case, that is the divergence case, the point of divergence of two ridges forms the point of delta. So this is about core and delta. Core is the inner terminus, that is the center portion, and arch do not have this core, but loops and whorls they have core. Then delta is the outer terminus, and by two means delta can form in the pattern, that is by bifurcation of the single ridge and divergence of the two ridges running side by side. So core, if this is a ridge pattern like this ridge patterns, this portion is called as core. Okay, then in delta, I will show you. So if imagine this is the, this is a ridge pattern. So this portion is core, and here you can see here, this is the delta. This is the delta, that is the point of bifurcation, that is bifurcation by single ridge or divergence of two ridges. One more I will show you. Core, and here ridge is going like this, and one single ridge is here. So this portion is delta, or you can say like this. So here two ridges will be there. So this portion will be delta. So this is the outer terminus of the here. So these portions are delta. So I hope you understood what is core and what is delta. Now we were discussing about loops. So loop is 60 to 65% population will be having a loop as fingerprint pattern. And now loop is divided into two. Loop are of two types, that is ulnar loop. You can tell this ulnar loop as U, and radial loop R. So ulnar loop, this loop is formed by ridges which entering from one side and flow back after recurving around the core to the same side of the opening of the loop, pointing towards radial ulnar bone. So as same as loop, the definition is same as loop, but the thing is that it will go and come and go to the ulnar bone side, that is the thumb, that is the little finger side. So this is the little finger. So to this side, for example, don't judge my drawing, okay? So this is the little finger. So the curve will be to the this side. It will go and come from to the this side. If it is a radial loop, it will go to the radial side. So to this side, this is thumb, this is little finger. So the loop enter and go to the little finger side in the ulnar loop, and to this thumb side, that to the, that is radial loop. So this is to the ulnar bone side, and this is to the radial bone side of the same hand. So that is about radial loop and ulnar loop. Next is whorl. So world is about 30 to 35% of the total population will have a world pattern, and world is a pattern having two delta and at least one ridge making a complete circuit. So in loop there is no complete circuit, it is going and coming to one side only. But in world, what is the thing is that it will form a complete circuit. So it has a two delta and one core. One core will be there and two deltas will be there. So this complete circuit, which may be of a spiral, oval and circular, or any variant of a circle. So these are of spiral, oval and circular, in any variant of circular shape. An imaginary line drawn between the two deltas must touch or cross at least one of the recurving ridges within the inner pattern. So I will show you this one. So this is the loop. So this is the world pattern, and if we these are the two deltas. So if we draw an imaginary line between the two deltas, they must touch or cross at least one of the recurving ridge. So this is the recurving ridge. So this will touch the recurving ridge when we draw an imaginary line between the two deltas. It will touch the across, or it will cross at least one of the recurving ridges within the inner pattern. So that is about world. Next is composite. So composites we can divide into central pocket. Central pocket loop, then lateral pocket loop, twin loop and accidental. So central pocket loop, this pattern combines features of both the loop and world. So in central pocket, both world and loop features will be there. And in this pattern, the majority of the ridges have the appearance of loop. So majority patterns are the appearance of loop, but in which one or more of the ridges within the pattern area recurve about the core, thus forming a pocket. So the ridges recur around the core to form a pocket. And if an imaginary line, if we draw between two deltas, that line does not cross or touch. In world, we said it will touch or it will cross the ridges. But in this central pocket loop, it will not cross. Imaginary line between two deltas will not cross or touch the recurving pattern. So that is central pocket loop. It shows the characteristics of both world and loop. That is, majority of that is of loop, and when the ridges recurving around the core to form a pocket. So that is the characteristic of world. And if the imaginary line between two deltas, if we draw, it will not cross or touch, but in world it will touch, but in central pocket loop it will not touch. So that is about central pocket loop. And next is lateral pocket loop. So lateral pocket loop, this is basically a double loop pattern. Double loop pattern. And it is formed by two loops. It is double loop pattern and formed by two loops. either overlapping or surrounding each other, and in which the ridges surrounding the cores of the loops terminate at the opposite side of the delta. Usually the loop pattern, what they will show the characteristic, like it will end at the same side where it started. But in central lateral pocket loop, what is the thing is that the loops terminate at the opposite side of the delta. In other words, both loop formations flow in the same direction with core lines without being divided by either of the deltas. Next is this, I can show you. So this is this central pocket. Here you can see a pattern of whorl, and other patterns are of loop. Next is double pocket. So this is like a double loop pattern. So here you can a S shape, and this is the loop. Here also there is loop. So the double loops are there in this pattern. And next is twin loop. Twin loop. So this is also a double loop pattern, and the pattern is formed by two loops either overlapping or surrounding each other and having a termination of the ridges representing the core of each loop separated by one of the deltas. Next is accidental. So accidental patterns which are too irregular to be placed in any of the above categories are called accidental. So we can't estimate the, or we can't say the shape of these patterns, and it will be in irregular shape. Sorry. In these patterns are formed by the combination of any two different types of patterns, except a combination of which one of the patterns in an arch. So accidental loops, when patterns are formed by loop over a plane arch, it is interrupted not as an accidental but as a Newton loop. So these are the patterns of fingerprints. I hope you understood. Next class we will continue. Thank you.